What's going on, guys? This is Dr. Technician, helping you go further faster in technical field. We're gonna be looking at how we can delete all types of different cache which is stored on the computer. We're going to be using just a manual way of removing this rather than using any software. So, if you are new here, consider subscribing and also hit bell icon for notification. Let's get into video. Coming up, it's a simple procedure but very effective, and we gonna show it as fast as possible. We are not using any third-party programs to perform this cleaning process, so you don't have to download another creepy tool to do this. For your information, cleaning the unwanted file from your C drive will make your Windows run much faster. It's always a good way to learn and know where this stuff is stored. So let's go ahead and take a look. First method, we're just going to the Explorer here, then into the C drive inside here. We're gonna go into the Windows directory inside here. We're gonna come down to where it says Software Distribution. Inside Software Distribution, this is where all your data. So, if you're going to Downloads here, this is your Windows Update data which is used, and then it doesn't need anymore. So you can get rid of all this stuff here. So you can see if I just put properties on, this has 776 megabytes, which is quite a lot. So, if you want to delete that, you can delete all this stuff inside here by just pushing the delete key, and it will delete that. Now, if it needs any of this stuff, it will automatically download anyway. So I'm just gonna get rid of this and do this to all of this content inside here and let that delete. Okay, that folder is now empty, and that one is done, so we can close it off. So next up, we're gonna go to the temporary now. To do this, just push the Windows key and let it run. Then that brings up the run box now. You can also bring up the run box by right clicking here on start and clicking on run here. Then type %temp, once again %, and this will take you to this location here, and you can now delete all the content inside here. These all are just temporary files that you can delete. So, let me go ahead and select all this stuff. You can delete that stuff and it won't hurt the computer. And so we'll just do that, and some of this stuff will be remain, because these are in using presently. Alright, next up we're going to go back into there again by pushing the Windows key and the letter R. So we'll open up the run box here, and now we're just gonna put in here temp, no %, and just open this up. It may say you don't have permission. Just click continue and it will open up this Windows area here, and you can delete all the contents inside here as well. This is just another area which you can delete, and I'm gonna delete all this stuff. Well, there we go, when that's all gone. So next up, what we want to do is get prefetch. You can do that by going back into the run again, and we're going to type prefetch just like so. Click OK, and it will give you the same thing again. Click continue, and this will open up your prefetch area, and we're gonna select everything here like so, and I'm just gonna delete it. There we go, and all that's gone. So that's the prefetch. There now another thing you can do is reset your Windows Store, and we can do that again by opening up run box, and what we're gonna do is type WS reset all one word like so, click OK, and this will open up the command prompt, and this will reset all of the Windows Store and get rid of all that data in there as well. For you it may take a bit of time, so be patient and let it do its thing, and it will continue and finish. There we go, that's done. So if you had any problems with your Windows Store, that will fix it and resolve it most of the time. Next up, what we're gonna do here is go to the start button, then go settings inside here. What you want to do is go to where it says privacy, click on this one here, go to your location, and inside here you want to come down, and you can see here it will sock clear history of this device. You can do that as well, and it will clear older history of this device, which is this computer. Alright, it's done. Here we go. Also, what you might want to do here is, go to your command prompt. So type cmd, right click on this and run this as administrator. This will open up this box here. And what you want to do here is, type ipconfig, then click slash, and type flush DNS, like so, and this will flush your DNS, and get rid of all the cache inside there as well. Just before I go, system restore is another place, where you might want to clear restore points. So if you open up the system restore area here, if you've got this on your computer, and what you want to do is go into the configure area, and you can claim back some space and see space used in my computer is 1.26 GB. So I'm gonna delete these here, and that's now claimed back 1.26 GB. And what you want to do here is click OK here, and then you want to create a new system restore point. OK, and you can call it whatever you like. I'm just gonna put clean here, and that will just take a restore point for me. And it cleans up lot space, and also sometimes you get a massive amounts of restore points inside here as well. Which you may want to remove and claim back space, so you can see here we've got usage back, and that's pretty much it. So that's how you can clean up your system cache by using these methods. Thanks again for watching, guys. Hope this one helps you out. Bye for now. If you haven't subscribed yet, hit the big red subscribe button on my YouTube channel, and hit the bell notification bar to be notified when we upload new videos. And until next time, Dr. Technician is helping you go further faster in tech. Keep crushing it, and we will talk soon.